Here are some local corporate headlines. Dito Telecommunity sells 1.6 billion common shares out of its unissued authorized capital stock. The shares, which amounted to a 10% stake, were sold at 1 peso apiece. Dito shares surged 4.4% in Wednesday trade. Meanwhile, Globe Telecom sells over 100 towers to Frontier Tower Associates for 1.4 billion pesos. To date, Globe has received over 26 billion pesos from Frontier Towers as Frontier gains ownership and management to over 2,000 towers. The telco giant also closed another 100 towers to Miascore Infrastructure for 1.2 billion pesos. Globe shares climbed a tenth of a percent. In corporate earnings, All Homes nearly doubles its first half bottom line to 440 million pesos. This despite its second quarter net income slipping 8%. The Villar-owned company cites a healthy sales uptake in soft and hard categories. All Homes shares rose 0.6%. The newly listed Repower Energy Development more than triples its first half bottom line to 95 million pesos. The company points to the full commercial operation of two additional plants. Year to date, its generation increased 58% to around 35 gigawatts. REDC shares stayed flat in today's trade. And finally, Bench founder Ben Chan celebrates the brand's 35th anniversary by taking over 400 employees to Hong Kong Disneyland. In an Instagram post, Chan said, "The employees are at the heart of Bench anniversary celebration." The Philippine finance chief warns against banning Chinese corporations in government projects. Secretary Benjamin Jokno told the Senate Finance Committee on Wednesday a ban could force the government to shoulder the expenses of projects requested from China. He adds, there could also be significant delays in locally funded projects and public-private partnerships with Chinese contractors, suppliers, or subcontractors.
May have the following potential effects, right? For example, implementation of official development assistance projects from bilateral and multilateral ODA partners alike, particularly for projects considering multiple country participation, including China, as a member of the Asian Development Bank, Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank, and the World Bank. So that it might affect the implementation of projects.
Asian markets ended Wednesday trade with losses. This is after stronger than expected retail sales from the U.S. raised fears of another rate hike from the U.S. Federal Reserve. Weak home prices data from China also weighed, with the Shanghai Composite and the Hong Kong Hang Seng posting their fourth straight day of declines. Here at home, Philippine shares bucked the regional downswing, with the main index jumping 1.2% to close back above 6,400. AAA Equities President Matthew Kabangon says people are trading technicals.
What we saw last week, the objectively horrendous GDP print, you know, took us down to that bottom of the range. Now, I think concerns were whether that would be enough to push us below that key level, but clearly it wasn't. Big names like SM Investments Corp, for example, the biggest weighted company in the index, it was up 3% today. So clearly, market participants took the chance to buy at supports, and from where we are now, probably have a bullish view.